Now that you have the images of both LDPE and skin sample saved in your file, we can start the DAC analysis through the GOM Correlate software. Open the application GOM Correlate. Select New Project. And save the file as your group number, team number, LDPE.gcorrelate. Go to File, Import, File, and select all of the images from your folder, group number, team number, LDP, and click Open. On the pop-up window, click Deformation Image. The images wanted for DIC analysis will appear. You can zoom with the wheel of your mouse and switch on and off your image mapping by clicking on the Image Mapping On logo on the bottom of your screen. Now, go to Operation, Stage, Manage Stages, and select all images with the Ctrl+A key combination. Then click the Edit Timestamp logo and set the starting time at 0 seconds and the step size to 0.5 seconds. Go to View, Timeline, Time to set the timeline at the actual elapsed time. We will now calibrate the image according to the actual values that we measured during the test. Unfold actual elements on the left of your screen. Then unfold measurement series. Right-click on deformation 1 and select Edit Creation Parameters. Click on the Edit Calibration tab. Select all stages for apply to and click on define scale. Keep the left control key pressed and click on the left and the right extremities of your sample where you measured the sample with previously. Input the width of your specimen as point distance. Now, to select the areas of analysis, go to Construct, Component, Surface Component. Click on the Select, Deselect Polygon logo on the bottom of the screen. Select the area by going around the incision and neglecting the flapping corners on the incised edge. Once selected, keep the right mouse button pressed down and slide to plus to create your selection. Then release the right mouse button. Fill in the popped-up window according to figure in the lab module. To assess the quality of your stochastic pattern, select Pattern Quality. On the unrolling menu on the bottom left of the popped-up window, next to the histogram on the right side of your screen, there should be a continuous half Gaussian distribution in its green portion. This shows that the pattern quality of your image is good. Otherwise, refer to the lab module for adjustment. Take a screenshot of this step and include it in your report. You can also assess the reference length of your DAC analysis by selecting Reference Length in the same unrolling menu. Don't forget to report the value of the narrow Gaussian distribution on the left of the histogram. Finally, click on Create and Close. The software will now compute the analysis. Now, to set up the coordinate matrix, go to View, 3D View Elements, Coordinate System and Origin. Then, Operation, Alignment, Manual Alignment, Set Matrix. You can move the coordinate system alongside its Y and X axis to put its origin on the crack tip of your sample. Then, align the X axis in the direction as the crack would spread and align the Y axis with the actual tension axis of your sample by slightly tilting the Z axis. We can now check for the technical strain of your sample in all directions. We start by the X direction. Select your surface component by left-clicking on it in the tree on the left of your screen. Then go to Inspection, check Dimensions, Strain, check epsilon x, and a window will pop up. There, input to check for the technical strain of your sample against the reference stage with an average spatial filter of 2 nodes. Go to View, Legend, Show Histogram. Then go to View, Legend, Edit Legend, and a window will pop up. Choose to display a legend referring to every image on a full scale, keeping only the mean plus minus 3 sigma of values to display. We do the same steps to check epsilon y and epsilon xy. Once you have several fields of values inspected, you can choose which you want to actually see on your screen by clicking on the toggle visibility option in the 3 on the left of your screen. For each inspected strain, epsilon x, epsilon y, epsilon xy, take a print screen of the results at the 10 second, including the scale. Insert them in your report. You should see the pattern of deformation in each direction. We'll further inspect the deformation pattern in the y-axis. To do so, display your epsilon y result by clicking on it in the tree on the left of your screen, and go to View, Legend, Edit Legend, and a window will pop up. Choose to display a legend referring to every image, but now choose GOM 3 colors as a template. Choose manual as min max, and edit the values for manual scaling as blue 0%, green 2%, yellow 15%, and red 19%. You will then be able to easily discriminate areas where strains are negligible in blue, under the maximum uniaxial command in green, in between the maximal command and the yield strain in yellow, and above the yield strain red. This corresponds to plastic deformation area. Take a print screen of the results at the 10 second and insert in your report. Make sure to go back to the first frame afterwards. This is very important. Now, go to Edit, Selection 3D, Main Selections, select All. Then go to Construct, Section, Single Section, and a window will pop up. Import a section of your surface component by a plan normal to the y-axis, coinciding with the origin. Click on Create and Close. Select your section by left-clicking on it in the tree on the left side of your screen. Then, go to Inspection, check Dimensions, Strains, check epsilon x, and a window will pop up. There, input to check for the technical strain of your sample against the reference stage, with an average spatial filter of 2 nodes, as you did previously. You can now repeat the last step to check epsilon y. We will now look for the yield area length. Go to the image taken at the 10 second and then click on the diagram tab. Under the orange header, click on the show diagram legend logo and then on the diagram settings logo. A window will pop up. In the general tab of this window, choose to display results with the same units together, and in the Curves tab, choose Project as X-axis and X plus as Project Onto. Click on OK and menu edit the min and max values of the Y-axis by clicking on it, and then on the lock. Report the length values where epsilon Y crosses the technical yield strength of the material currently being analyzed,